Hello and welcome to another Nicomedia tutorial. I'm happy that I finally found time for another tutorial. Sorry for this long waiting in between, but I'm really busy at the moment. And most of the tutorials I have on my list, they need about 2-3 hours at least. And so I just can make my shorter ones at the moment. But I hope really that until the next week it's getting more quiet here and I can make more for you, because I love to make tutorials for you, of course. But here, this should go. This should need not so long. So let's do it. I made this small test animation here. This is just a test, and posted it on my Facebook site. And I got many questions how I did this. And this looks like this. And yeah, this we will do today. I want to show you how to bring this to glowing and everything, and we do this with the physical render, not in the Octane render. In the Octane render it would work a little different, but let's start. Yeah, many people ask me why I still work on R18. There's a simple reason. In R19 there is not a really working version of Octane for R19 at the moment, and so it makes me a little angry, but what shall I do? So I still work on R18 and it works perfect, and why not? If you have questions about R19 or something, so you can ask, of course. I have installed R19 too, so it should be no problem. And yeah, let's start here with this one now. And yeah, I start with two walls, and this is a hair. And on the hair, we make a sweetener up here, and so on. So I don't think we need to make this. Well, let's see what we need and what we do. Let's start with just two walls, or two whatever, or two cubes. Doesn't matter. I make two cubes, but not so. Let's say here 50, here 450. Okay, this is one cube, and I need here some segments in the Y. Let's say 15, and in the Z, let's say 1. Okay, this is nice. I like this cube, make it editable. Hit C on your keyboard. Now I edge mode. And yeah, I make, okay, now I make just two walls. So it was other thing in mind, but now I make two walls. So UB for a loop selection, select all these edges here and delete them, and we have two walls. We can now simply drag them a little. Oh, so here something like that. 250s. Okay, this is should be okay. And to grow hair on this, hair grows every time in the normal direction. So if I select all you see, the orange color is the normal direction. And I want to grow hair to the inside here, so I have to reverse my normals. And this you do simply with UR on the keyboard, UR, and you have reversed your normals. You can just right click in the viewport, and here you have it too. Okay, now I select some points. Make it here, this is easier. Here, select this one with Control Shift click here, Shift click, Control Shift click, and now Control click on the point mode, and I've selected the points here. I don't need the first and the last ones here, so it's easier than to go through this thing. You can do it however you want. And now I save the selection, so I say set selection. But I have it here in my toolbar. If you don't have it in the toolbar, select and set selection here. Okay. And with this selection selected, this selection selected, I go to my simulate and hair objects and hate add hair. Click on add hair, and because we have selected these points and everything, it automatically takes the hair, take the point selection, and grows just on these points. Okay, this is nice so far, and you see it grows to the inside, exactly what we want. But the hairs are too long. So I go to my count here, so go to 50. This should work. Maybe 40. We can change this later on. Let's see, 50. Or 45. 45. 50? No, that doesn't matter. So segments, I don't need as many segments. 4 is here enough. The count is okay. So the 28 points we selected. Now we go to the hair and say here on the roots, not to auto, we go to as guides. So the hair does exactly the same as the guides. The next thing I would want is, yeah, if I click now on play, you see the hair fall down, and I don't want that they fall down. Sorry. So I go to the forces here, and gravity, nothing, zero. And now when I hit play, that's exactly what I want. The next thing is, we want to make sweep nerves out of this hair. So for the sweep nerve, you know, we need two spline. One for the path and one for the profile of the sweep. So let's go to our hair and say under generate, we say not, so we don't render hair, so we didn't render sweep. Not known, we go to sweep, to spline here. And so we have the first spline for the path. Now we need a profile spline. I take here a circle spline, make it of course smaller. Let's say so 10 about, that's too much, 5. Okay, and now I select my circle, go to the sweep nabs, hold the Alt key and click on sweep. So now we have the profile spline. At first comes the profile spline and then the path spline. And you see we have sweep nabs here. But I see the circle is too many segments. So we could do something like adaptive, make this angle bigger. So go to 20 degree. So this is okay, but you see this is not uniform and I want uniform. So I go to uniform and here 3 is enough. It's less is enough. 2, 1, even 1 is okay because we then at the end we put this in a subdivision surface. So this is okay with 1. Nothing. 0 is too less. This is too less. So next thing. I want on the caps. I want here in the sweep. Close this and the caps. I want N-guns and I want to create a single object. So, here I have N-guns and here we don't have N-guns. That's funny. I'm not sure if it's really funny, but it's okay for the moment. So now I want to make something like a drop shape here. And so we go to my sweep and here are the details. Let's play with this window here, with this spline. You see, when we drag this down, we have this. Okay. And here, with the control click, you can add points. Control click on the spline. I'll go down here. So something like this. This is okay for me. And now under caps, I make here a fillet cap. And I want to constrain it. So, but you see they overlap here. So that means we have to go down with the radius here to 4 is okay. And Let's see how this looks when we put this in a subdivision surface. It looks quite nice. And we could go to the sweep and give it another step here. So, yeah, that looks better. Three steps. That looks better. Okay. We have our drop shape, and now it's still no n-guns, but what shells, let's see. Quadrangles, triangles, n-guns. That's funny. It should work no matter what, but it doesn't matter for us, so it is simply doesn't matter. So this is nice now. And now we wanna make a sphere and go through this, and when it touches these things, they should glow. And of course they should move a little bit. Good, so far. Let's make a sphere. Let's make the sphere a little smaller, so something like that, that touches the drops here. Let's see from the side, if it's in the middle, that's okay. And go up here with this here. So we have here splines now and hair. So we need here on this sphere, I go to the hair tags and want here a hair collider. This should collide with the hair. Means I make here a longer timeline. Let's see. 1,000 frames, so that we can longer play with it. When I now hit play here, nothing happens, but when I go down with the sphere here, you see, it does something. And it looks quite funny. But it's not the movement I want. So, come back here. And let's play with this, with the dynamic. Under properties, here we have something to play with. Let's see what we can do. First, stiffness, this is all nice. Okay. Let's see the rest mix here. Let's go to 50. Hit play. Go to the sphere. And. Okay, it does something. Go back to here. Stop this for a moment. I go here to this lock here. So when I click on the sphere, I don't lose my settings here for the hair, so I don't have to go back forward. So let's see what we can do here. Drag is. Okay, rest hold not empty. This is just how you like it, so just find your right settings. And again, whoops. This is not 100, does nothing. Yeah, this was quite clear. Okay, better. Rest hold 30 maybe. Yeah, that looks not bad. Let's try again. Okay. The rest mixer is told. 10 and 70. Okay, this is 10 and here 50. Yeah, this is what I want. This is exactly what I want. Okay, we have this. Let's save it. As you see, I made a new project and named it Sweep Glow, so I know what to do. Just save it, And this should work fine here. Under advanced, we need nothing. Let's see. Yeah, the next thing is when we go, let's go back here and start it. I want not to to intersect so much. It will intersect anyway, but not, I don't want to intersect so much. So I can play here with the surface radius. Let's see, I go here to 10. It's too much. 8. 8 looks good. Okay. So. You see, here it intersects anyway, but we don't see this because we go through and you don't will see this. This is annoying here, so now it's better. Okay. And now go back and I want just 100 frames, okay. And now I want a square render at the end, so 720, okay, make a camera and see the camera, so lock it, coordinates null, not null, zero, null is tennis, here, zero, now we are exactly in the middle, but I want here maybe an focus length. Let's see, so portray should work, and 80. Let's see. Okay, this is nice. Good so far. And let's animate this sphere from here to here. Let's animate this sphere from here to here. So camera is okay. Give it a protection tag. So, and save. Now I go here. A little up with the sphere so that I don't see it in our render in the beginning. So something like here. Okay. Give it a keyframe, so on frame 0 and keyframe the y-axis, just click on it. Now we go to frame 100, bring down our sphere, okay, and again, whoops, now we have a keyframe here, and if we go back here and render it. It looks good, but I don't want an easy, so I want a linear movement here. So I click here, right, go to animation, say F-curve. And I see here I have an easy, and Control A to select the whole curve, and here go to this symbol to linear. Whoop, and this is what I want. And when I go back, I have every time the same speed. And that looks nice. Maybe let's make it a little faster the sphere, because then the last drops here can move out. So let's say we have here the keyframe of the sphere, and let's drag this to maybe 80. Let's see how this looks now. Yeah, that's okay. We could make the timeline to 150. This would be the same. Yeah, we can do this. Let's bring this back to 100. And simple. Oops. Control Z. Let's bring this back to 100 here. Here 100. And and make the keyframe 125. Oh, the time length 125. Because I don't want that the sphere goes too fast. To okay, 150. This renders quite fast later, so that we don't have to be worried about anything. So, yeah, now they stop here. And if we make a loop, it comes again from above. Okay. Okay, go back here, save it. And now we start to play with this glowing thing here. So for this, we need, you won't believe it, but we need a texture, a shader. So first, let's bring something like here, so we can see something. And make a new material, double click on the material manager and double click on the material. And now I go to the luminance channel and want something luminant. So how we do this now? With a proximal shader. And I want that the drop lights as soon as it touches the, or a little before and a little after with the sphere. So I go to here, effects, proxima shader. Bang. So now I have to make my sphere editable because you see it works with edges and vertices. And as long as we have no converted sphere, we don't have vertices and edges. So I just hit C on the sphere and drag it inside here. And say use. So at the moment when I put this material on the sweep here, you see we have this. And let's render this. You see it works. It works now. I did not much and it works with this thing. Use vertices and use edges I want. And here I go to smooth. The next thing I want is go to lighten. And here the end distance. You see now we have lighten almost everything here. Go to the end distance 20. You see. This is exactly what we want. Maybe 30. And now, it doesn't matter where we are with this, with our sphere. Exactly where we are, there are these things here. They are lit here. So this drops here. And I made here some pattern in the original one. See, we did some stripes here. So let's make this now. For this, we need this proximal shader is okay. This is what I like. But we need another thing. We need a layer shader. And I bring in a gradient. Bam, bam, bam. Where are my gradient? Whoops. Okay. Now I want it. I load my preset, so I have this black and white preset. You can make it by your own. Just make it and then save preset. So this is this, and I want it vertical. You see, I have now. You can go closer with the go out of the camera and. Hide the camera and go closer here. Okay. I don't care about this ending now here because we did this in another with the glowing spline thing. I made a tutorial where I did this where I explained this so how you can make this a nice Transition part for this tutorial, it's okay, we don't need this here. Just want to play with just that it worked. But so okay, what we see here now is it works everywhere. So we don't have this just where the sphere is. And I want color too. So the first thing is I want an effect, and here I take a colorizer. Or do I need a colorizer? And delete this colorizer and try to shader the colorizer. But I don't think, no, the colorizer was okay. Effect, colorizer. And here I can again bring in a load preset, and let's say I want this heat preset. And I have these nice things here, these nice stripes. Okay. Far as good. And here in the proximal shader, we want to see it like before, where we have seen just where it touches. You know what I mean. So go to here and just click on layer mask. You see it in the preview, and you see it here. It works great. Okay. And this is nice. So, but now, of course, we want to make this looking a little better, everything. What you can do is, you have here this color, so we can take this gradient in here. Copy this gradient, copy shader, go to my color, paste it here. Can't paste it, it doesn't matter, I know what I did, so I go to my gradient. This is not so much work to. So, and here on V, that's okay. Okay, and take the colorizer too. So, but here we can take the shader colorizer. Okay. And make this darker. Go here to multiply. So, because I just want, if they are not touched, I want to see them a little bit anyway. So this is the reason I make this here. If we make this brighter, you see. So. But I just want to see them just a little bit before. So do you know they are here, but okay. Maybe we don't need the color later, because when we make here a reflectance channel and make an environment where something is to reflect, this should work too. And we will do this. So let's make here and reflectance channel, and I bring in my Nicomedia scene rig, of course. Okay, but without a floor, you see it. We have some reflections here, this is nice, and we darken the background. Here, if your background brightness, whoops. That's okay. So this is what I meant. So we don't need the color here. Now we see it anyway because we have this. But it is much too much reflection. And we can go down here with the reflection brightness too. And I don't want light intensity so much. So. Oh, maybe this is so down with the reflection brightness. Yeah, that's better. Okay, nice. And this looks good so far, but I think with the color this is not so bad, because we see the stripes a little when we do. Yeah, this is nice with the color. Okay, Now let's make some something for the sphere here, material. This is the drops. Let's see, drops. And now let's make a material for the sphere, maybe a simple glass material or something else. Let's see what we can. I don't know what I used in my. As I said, this was just a quick test I did before, but I got so many questions about this. And transparency, reflectance, transparency with 1.517, which is glass, and put it on our sphere. Dong. Nice, but I don't want to see in the HDRI settings. I don't want to see the refraction. Nice. Okay, this is good. 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 Ah, I like it. This kid is okay for me so far. We could make it and we can blur it a little bit, but this is again more render time, of course. And it brings, you see, it's not really much difference. So let's go up with the. And yeah, what we should have done is bring this sphere, give this sphere more segments, because when we make it editable. The render perfect doesn't work anymore. You see it, it's not rendered perfect. But you can of course put this in the sweep maps too. And we have a nice round sphere. And what we could do is, let's see how this looks when we put this in the simulate cloth surface. Alt click. So first I selected the sphere, then Alt click on the cloth surface. I don't need subdivisions, I just want to make a thickness here. And I think this looks nice. Looks somewhat like socks here. Let's see it. I think this looks good. Yeah, this looks good. I think I like it. Yeah, it's better than the original. So, and now we can make the things I did with the walls, with the stone walls and something else. How did I do this? Yes, I know. Of course I know. But go to my cube here. Go out of the camera. Wing. Make here something like UL. Okay, boundary loop. Yeah, so, and T for scale, and I hold my control key and scale this up. So I make something like walls. Let's see. Good. So what we need now is make it higher. So. Let's go inside here. Whoop. UL. Now no boundary loops. Of course. So, and drag this up here, and this, drag it up with control, it doesn't matter. So I go back here, so just delete this one here, this one, bye bye, same I do here on the bottom, bye bye. And now we can do the same like before. I make an UM for a path selection. So I select this path here. Hold by shift key, select this too here. Same on the top. Whack. Shift key and select. Same here. Select. Okay. Now I go in my camera. I know we have everything selected here, so now I hit T for scale and just control drag this just in the Y direction, control and drag sometimes, so we have some segments for displacement. Okay, that's enough. Good, so what can we do now? We can give some displacement here. Some subdivisions here, so UB for this and this, and MF for edge cut, and give it here, I don't know, let's say 5, no angles please, and apply. So now we have some segments, and we can play with some displacement and make something like stones here. Yeah, I do it with, I would do it now with the, come on, with the real displacement textures, but we can do this now here with a normal, just to show how it works with a normal displacement, with a normal noise. Make here something, a displacement first, this and a displacement. Noise. Which noise can we take here? We can take everything, but okay, this looks nice. Do the maybe put it on our cube here and let's see what we get. Okay, this is not much. Go to the displacement, subdivision displacement, subdivision, okay. Subdivision level is nice, so maybe texture not 2D. Yeah, better. Make it a little bigger. Camera. See what we get. Okay, that looks not so bad. Displacement, go around. Okay, nice. Now let's make something like a nice. I copy this noise here. Go to the color channel, paste the noise in here. Okay, then. Okay, make a colorizer here, so colorizer, go to the load presets and we have your flame and heat and scene one, this is something like a stone-ish thing here, that's not really stone-ish, maybe if you're stoned then it's stone-ish. It's the same now, I took the same, of course. Man. Funny. Don't want this one, don't want this one, don't want this one. Distribute knots. No, this is nothing. I don't like this. So. And when I don't like it, what do? I just go to my Shift F8, go to my textures and see what I have here. Stone, and if you're realistic stone material, I'll bring it out here and put this on my wall here. Okay, displacement, Oops. Aha, okay. Then I take here in the displacement my noise instead of this picture here. So I know now 200 and I want my Naki. And weiter ist es. Did I miss something around geometry, of course? Normal. Away with the normal here. Away with the diffusion. I just want to show you something. That's funny. You know what? I take the color channel, copy this, go back, take my material here, go in the color channel and paste my color channel here. Clear, paste. It doesn't have to fit, so. Ah, this is a color channel. This is the reason why it looks so. Okay, then make some colorize things. Control set, so go to the colorizer again and take my own colors. Let's make some brown color here, so and cancel, bye bye. Copy this, control drag it away, and you have a copy and make it just a little so and make it smooth. Something like that. That looks by far not like stone, but I think you get the idea. As I said, I used the real displacement on my original one, and don't know. Do I have here something here in Shift F8? Let's see. I think I don't. That's not my. Floor looks funny too. Let's see how floor looks. Just put it on my. Oh, this is everything with textures. So with pictures, you get very fast some you know what I mean, some tiling effects. This is nothing. We can go here to cubic. Oops. Let's take this realistic material and make a cubic mapping. Ah, that's better. Did I delete here my things? Go back. Ah, now we are here. Okay, this still works. And now, cubic. What's that? Oh, this is the floor now. That's funny. But I want this realistic thing here. But why didn't. Okay, now. But this is everything much too bright here. So let's see what we can do here. Light intensity down. Doesn't help anymore because we have this. Wait. Let's go to GI. First, I 720 this. Okay, now we're talking. Yeah, that was the reason because this light intensity didn't work because we worked without GI. Yeah, that's it so far. So you see that this renders quite fast. So if we make now an animation out of this, we have 150. Go to the render settings. Take the middle GI settings. 720. Go to the middle one. Output. I don't want to save something now, but I see all frames now. And just try the first frames, how fast it works. And every time be sure you have the same frame rate here, like in your control D is the project settings. And here the FPS, they have to be the same. Sometimes you see, you would have 151 frames is okay. But sometimes you have a totally different number there, and this is the reason is most of the this that you have another frame rate here, like in your project settings. So every time be careful that you have the same frame set settings here and here, the same frame rate. So now hit render. Yes, I know I don't want to. You see that it renders quite fast, and should render quite fast too. But we can make something like. Make it smaller here, we don't need the big 400 just for see what we get. So but why does it that's I don't like. Something is not correct here. Let's go back. Oh, here I did something wrong here. Somehow I did something here with the coordinates. Just move it up. And and here we can move the sphere up a little bit. I'll go to frame 100 and move the sphere up. So, okay. Now that should work. Go back here. Let's see. Okay. And now hit render. Okay. And now render this and let's see what we get. It renders really quite fast, so we can. This. I will stop now the recording and I'm back when this is done. So see you in a second. So you see I'm now here on frame 50 and you see it works perfect. And but I think I don't have to render now the entire animation. But you see it works. And it works great. And this is the way I have done this. And if you want to do this in Octane, you have to work with the plane effector and with the MoGraph color shader. Then you can make this with a falloff in the shader effector. So you have to, or not, in with the falloff in the plane effector. Make just a spherical falloff around this. Around the sphere, and then this is. If you want to see how this works in Octane, just write it in the comments or write it on my Facebook site, please. And yeah, but the only thing is, when you do this with the Fallout, you won't get this wonderful, just not totally litten drops. You know what I mean? This is great. So maybe I don't know when there comes an usable update for Octane. So maybe then the Proximal Shader works there. So we will see. But for now, this is it. And I hope you like this tutorial. And yeah, I hope tomorrow is Sunday, and at this time, tomorrow I would have a day off normally. So, but I can't promise that I can do something. But if I find time, of course I will do something. The next thing will be something like this. One guy sent me this. This Aorus thing here, and wants to know. Yes. No, this is not what it is. So now, yeah, I stop this. You see, it works, so I don't have to can stop here this render, I think. You will get the project file, of course. You will find everything you need in the description. So, and now the next thing is the Aorus. Someone sent me this MPEG here and wants to know how to make this effect here. So, we will do this. This will be one of the next tutorials too. And yeah. And yeah, this will maybe make, and this will I do in Octane, because in Octane we have the wonderful light effects and everything, so that this we don't have in the physical render. And yeah, stop it. Okay. So, and as I said, I will try to make tomorrow the next tutorial. And I have some I have many tutorials on my list, but and I really will try to work through every tutorial on my list, and there is a lot. Yeah, this is this for today, and hope you liked it. And if you have any questions, requests, or comments, or if you want to tell me what I can do better, or yeah, if you want to tell me something, hey, this was not so nice, or whatever, you know what I mean. Just write me everywhere where you can, on the comments, Facebook site, website, email, blah blah blah. And please, I really would appreciate it if you post your results, your tutorial results. On my new, now it's not new anymore, on my Facebook group, where you can post every tutorial results and everything. But please post there just tutorial results and questions. Not like many people do. They just post a picture or something else and they write nothing to it, and nothing, just a picture, and here, take it. Of course, this is I delete immediately. There's no question about it, and it can be beautiful as hell, but I delete it if I don't have any description or something else. So I delete it. So okay, and yeah, you will find a link to the donation, of course, if you want to donate, and I really love if people donate. Who does not? And then I really appreciate it. And you will find a link to my Patreon page. And yeah, and this year I will start to make special tutorials for just only for patrons. Maybe it will be some sci-fi scene or something else, and some picture what I did recently. I don't know where it is now. This should be somewhere. Let's see where. This is not easy. Yeah, this is this picture I did here, and maybe something like this here. And yeah, that's it for today, as I said. And I wish you a nice evening or morning or whatever, wherever you are. And hope you like this tutorial. And I am back as soon as possible. Believe me, I promise. Okay, so yeah, and if you want to the Comedia Scenery Pro, the link is in the description, of course, too. So, and yeah, for the Nikomedia Scenery Pro, there will come soon an update. Some new things, some bug fixes, and yeah, and I will try to make something for R19 now that we can use the shaders are not new, but so that we can use the viewport. And yeah, and as soon as a new update for Octane is out, I will make an update for my Octane Scenic. But at the moment, it's senseless. It's nothing because I don't know what comes. So, okay. So, yeah, now it's the end. Okay. I really wish you all the best and the best regards from Vienna. And yeah, tschüss und baba.